Good morning, everybody. Really good to have you all here. I'm just checking for my audio, although it's been checked by the backend team, but I'll still check once again. So I really hope you're all doing well, and I'm going to continue with our series on DOJAT. Last Friday, I took the first session. It's a five-part series. Initially, maine aapko four kaha tha, but I'll make it five. So last Friday was the first one. Right, today the voice is absolutely correct. After a while, I must admit. Right. So today is the second of the part. As I said, there will be five classes overall, 15 questions in each of them. So we'll be covering a total of 75 current affairs questions that you can understand. It's quite a bit. So let us get going without any further delays. Right. But first of all, my name, you know, Aritro Dasgupta, and I've been with Greta for about 6 months now. Like, it feels a really long time. And of course, we are running this crash course right now. You can see the number at the bottom of the screen. This is a batch for BBA Foundation, and we are there on Instagram as well. You may call us at the numbers which are present at the bottom. Right, let's move ahead to the next slide. Yeah, so we are also running this 10% off right now. There is this code called NEW10. Isko please use kiji, and then you will get a flat 10% off. So jo the one which is for 30,000 becomes 27,000, and I don't know, isme thoda sa, there seems to be some anyway, I'll just get back to you guys on this exact. Maybe tomorrow's class I'll give you the exact thing. But for now, you can use this code NEW10. The numbers don't seem to add up, but you can just add this, right? Okay, so let's start with the first question. I hope you guys are all ready. Can you give me a confirmation if you guys are ready? Right. I can't see many answers, but fair enough. Let's just go ahead with it. So which institution has organized the first edition of the Indo-Pacific Business Summit in partnership with the External Affairs Ministry? Right. So this is an institute. It is not a, but they work a lot with the ministry. One is FICCI, another is CII. There's the Niti Aayog, and there's the NASSCOM. Niti Aayog, I think you guys know, it is the successor organization to the Planning Commission. Been a couple of years in place now. Niti stands for National Institution for Transforming India. It is the national level think tank. That is government body, but it's not a ministry. The other three are private bodies, which they are industry-based bodies, which take in a lot from, do a lot of work with the government. Right. On that note, let us move ahead to the solution. The answer is actually CII. Please mention this, all of you. Please note down. CII is the first organization which has come up with the is the organization which has come up with the first edition of the Indo-Pacific Business Summit in partnership with the External Affairs Ministry. So that's pretty much it, guys. Turn on the highlighter. Yeah, so this is the answer. Please mention this, all of you. CII. Okay, chaliye. Moving ahead to the next slide. So there are 15 questions and there are 15 explanations. So this is the explanation for the first one. The first edition of the Indo-Pacific Business Summit was organized by CII in partnership with the External Affairs Ministry. The event saw participation from ambassadors and high commissioners of various countries across the Indo-Pacific. Indo-Pacific, by the way, this is a new name for the Asia-Pacific. It was earlier called Asia-Pacific, which included all the countries of Asia and those from the along the Pacific Ocean. But now the definition has been extended to Indo-Pacific because Indo here refers to the Indian Ocean. So it also includes countries from East Africa. So do pay attention on this particular term, Indo-Pacific. As I said, it's a successor to the Asia-Pacific. Now, addressing this event, the Secretary of the East in the External Affairs Ministry, Ms. Reva Ganguly Das, she spoke about promoting trade facilitation in the Indo-Pacific through improved cross-border linkages and trade infrastructure. She also underlined the importance of a free, open, inclusive and rules-based Indo-Pacific in facilitating trade and connectivity in the region. In the context of the Indo-Pacific, you need to know about this organization, guys. So I'm just putting it out, quad. Quad is short for quadrilateral. I just realized today is the first class of this particular month. So really good to connect with you guys on that. Quad is short for quadrilateral. It includes four countries. Can anybody tell me which are those four countries? Right, let's move ahead to the next one. Now, the Indian actor, I'll come back to Quad. Indian actor, after whom the Indian Army has named a military firing range in Gulmarg. Gulmarg, of course, in Jammu and Kashmir. Is it Rani Mukherjee, Tapsee Pannu, Vidya Balan and Hema Malini? Four options. Let's see if you can answer that. Please put your answers on the chat window. We are not doing an app-based class. App mein aapko malum hai, answer app mein dena padta hai, usmein poll aata hai. Isme the system is different. Right, so these are the four Indian actresses as part of this thing. Cannot see any answer as yet, so I'll move ahead to the explanation. It is Vidya Balan because she's made tremendous. So the answer is point number C. She's made tremendous contribution to Indian cinema. So the Indian Army has understood this thing, and so they have named this in Gulmarg as Vidya Balan firing range. Earlier this year, Vidya, along with her husband Siddharth Roy Kapoor, another famous actor, they had even attended the Gulmarg Winter Festival, which was organized by the Indian Army. Right, a few days ago it was announced that she's been invited to join the Academy of Motion Pictures and Sciences, the AMPAS, which is basically the governing body behind the Oscars. Oscars are the nickname, officially though they are known as the Academy Awards, since they are presented by the AMPAS. Right, so on that note, let us move on to the next question. This person has been appointed the brand ambassador of Khadi Prakritik Paint. Is it Sri Nitin Gadkari, who's a union minister, fellow union minister Smriti Irani? Is it the Prime Minister, Mr. Narendra Modi, or another union minister, Prakash Javadekar? I think after the cabinet reshuffle, Mr. Javadekar is no longer, at least one of his ministries has been reduced. He had a number of ministries. We'll go through this cabinet reshuffle in some time, but these are the options. Let's see if you can answer this. Right, let's move ahead. Let's see the answer. He was the MSME minister, Sri Nitin Gadkari. He's become the brand ambassador of this thing. He will promote this paint across the country to encourage young entrepreneurs to take up the manufacturing of cow dung paint. He inaugurated a new automated manufacturing unit of the KPP in Jaipur, capital of Rajasthan. He even appreciated the KVIC, or the Khadi Village Industries Commission, for the successful research. What exactly is Khadi Prakritik Paint? Let us understand. It has immense potential for creating sustainable development for the benefit of the poorest of the poor, and the target should be setting up a Prakritik Paint unit in each and every village. What is it? It is paint created from cow dung. You know, India has more than 200 million cows, and of course, enormous amount of cow dung which is generated. So if even a percentage of that could be used for something as beneficial as this, this can lead to tremendous, you know, development. Cow dung generally, as a source of energy, its efficiency level is low, but then you're getting it for free, so might as well make use of that, right? And it has been used traditionally for a lot of stuff. Yes, Prakriti, you're absolutely correct. Prakriti and Rihan, good to see you guys here. Prakriti, good that you are attending session from app here. So the cross platform thing is working well. Okay, the AFC Women's Asian Cup 2022 will be hosted by which two cities of India? AFC is the Asian Football Confederation. It's a regulatory body for football in Asia. So let's see, what will they be hosting? Where will they be hosting? Is it Kolkata and Hyderabad? Is it Bhubaneswar and Ahmedabad? Mumbai and Pune, or Bengaluru and Chennai? Which of these four options? Guys, do not Google. Please try to answer on your own. If you cannot answer, no problem. But do try on your own. Right, Rihan and Prakriti. I really hope one of you can do it. Right, let's move on to the next. Let's look at the understanding. Okay, so the answer is Mumbai and Pune, but initially it was Bhubaneswar and Ahmedabad. Bhubaneswar, please understand, has a world-class hockey stadium. It is one of the best in India. It did host a lot of matches in among the recent Women's Hockey World Cup. It was the main venue for that. So it was initially chosen. But hockey ka ek difference with football is the hockey usually uses AstroTurf pitches. International hockey uses AstroTurf or artificial grass. Football mostly, except for in some countries, uses natural grass. So newer venues at Mumbai and Pune, both from Maharashtra. This move was taken by the AFC to minimize the travel time. Obviously, Bhubaneswar and Ahmedabad, massive distance. Mumbai, Pune has the least distance. So to minimize the travel time and maintain an optimum biosecure bubble for the players, both in the same state, so it'll be easier to coordinate. Even Kolkata and Bhubaneswar would be close to each other, but different states. So that leads to certain complications. Tournament will be held next year. It was supposed to be held earlier, but due to COVID, kept on getting delayed. But now it's next year, 20th Jan to 6th February. So these are the three football stadiums. One of them is in Pune, Chhatrapati Sports Complex. The other two, one of them is in Mumbai, Andheri Sports Complex, and the DY Patil Stadium, which has been hosting a lot of IPL matches over the years. This, of course, in Navi Mumbai. So four spots for the finals. They were topped by India, Japan, Australia, and China. The other 28 teams will compete for the remaining eight spots. ठीक है. बाय द वे, क्वाड मेंबर्स, इट रिमाइंड्स मी, इंडिया, जापान, ऑस्ट्रेलिया एंड यूएसए, दोज फोर कंट्रीज द मेंबर्स ऑफ क्वाड. एंड इनफैक्ट चाइना इज द मेन रीजन इट्स बीन फॉर्मड. दिस ऑर्गेनाइजेशन इज ऑफन कंसिडर्ड एन एंटी चाइना ऑर्गेनाइजेशन. इंडिया, जापान, ऑस्ट्रेलिया एंड यूएसए, एंड चाइना इज ऑफ कोर्स अ मेजर प्लेयर इन इट. सो इट्स इंटरेस्टिंग द फोर कंट्रीज हियर. लेट्स मूव ऑन टू द नेक्स्ट वन. हु बिकम्स द न्यू मिनिस्टर ऑफ द रेलवेज? Right, this is an interesting question because I was just telling you guys about the cabinet reshuffle. So definitely based around the recent cabinet reshuffle. Okay, no problem, Rihan. At least keep attempting, keep trying. If you can answer. Right, okay, I've given you enough time. Let's see. Ashwini Vaishnav, that is the name. He becomes the new Railway Minister of India. He takes charge. He also took charge as the Minister of Communications, Minister of Electronics and Information Technology. The Jaipur-born Mr. Vaishnav was a brilliant student from the beginning, and after graduating with a gold medal in Electronics and Communications Engineering course from the Jai Narayan Vyas University in Rajasthan in 1992, he also pursued an M.Tech from IIT Kanpur. He immediately pursued the coveted civil service examination with an All India rank of 27 in 1994. That's exceptional. You know, you need to be brilliant to crack the UPSC. No two ways about it. And to be 27 that particular year is truly exceptional. Let's move on. We've done one of the cabinet reshuffle. Let's do one more. The new health minister of India. These are the four options. Mansukh Mandavia, Mr. Amit Shah, Kiran Rijiju, or Mr. Jyotiraditya Sindhya. Which of these four is the new health minister of India? Yes, that is correct, Rihan. You once again got the answer correct. Do help me with likes and shares, guys. Do spread the word to the others. And the next couple of days also we'll be having classes. Today is the second class. Tomorrow is the third. Friday is the fourth. Monday will be the fifth one. That is how we have planned this particular series. ठीक है, चलिए, लेट्स सी द आंसर. मनसुख मंडाविया, द आंसर इज ए. ही इज अ राज्यसभा मेंबर फ्रॉम गुजरात. ही इज द न्यू हेल्थ मिनिस्टर. ही रिप्लेसेस डॉक्टर हर्षवर्धन, हु वाज इन चार्ज अंटिल रिसेंटली. या सो ही इज आल्सो इन चार्ज ऑफ केमिकल्स एंड फर्टिलाइजर्स. आई एम टॉकिंग मिस्टर मंडाविया, आल्सो इन चार्ज ऑफ केमिकल्स एंड फर्टिलाइजर्स. प्लीज राइट दिस डाउन, इट्स एन इंपॉर्टेंट पार्ट. Important cheez hai, aap log likh lijiye. Yes, that is correct. Ritik, welcome to this session. You've done well. You've started on a very good note, Ritik. Good to see that. Yes, Prakriti, you were also correct. I think there is a lag. You know, there's a significant lag between me showing you the question and your answers. Maybe you are typing early. It's coming to me a bit later. Anyway, let's move on to the next question. Okay, Amazon India has launched its first digital Kendra. It's part of a commitment to digitize 10 million Indian MSMEs. You know, MSMEs, micro, small, and medium enterprises. Right. Let's see if you can answer this question. This is a question which has been covered a few times in the various sessions of late. So let's take it ahead. Okay, so Amazon India, they've launched its first this thing in Gujarat, in the city of Surat. There were two options from Gujarat, so answer number B is correct. It is to digitize 10 million Indian MSMEs. 2025 is the cutoff year. Amazon Digital Kendras, these are brick and mortar resource centers to provide MSMEs information about the benefits of e-commerce and help avail third-party services such as shipping and logistics support. Yeah, just wanted to check the audio once again. Seems to be doing good today. So this is about the benefits of e-commerce and help avail third-party services such as shipping and logistics support, cataloging assistance, digital marketing services, GST and taxation support to start their digital journey. These are a lot of these teething problems that MSMEs suffer from. Okay, now who has been appointed as the Minister of Charge? This is a very easy question of the newly formulated Ministry of Cooperation in the new cabinet created by the Prime Minister. Very easy question. Sir, what are we doing? Are we covering and not entire 9 months. I am right now doing mostly in the from the month of July. These questions are mostly from July. Ritik and Prakriti, you are right. ठीक है रिहान, आई होप आई हैव आंसर्ड योर क्वेश्चन. आई विल बी कवरिंग क्वेश्चन फ्रॉम जून, जुलाई एंड ऑगस्ट इन दीज कपल ऑफ क्लासेस. एज आई टोल्ड यू, देयर विल बी टोटल 5 क्लासेस, सो मोस्टली कवरिंग फ्रॉम दीज 5 मंथ्स. ठीक है रिहान, आई होप आई हैव बीन एबल टू आंसर योर क्वेश्चन. ठीक है, वेरी इजी क्वेश्चन, आई होप यू हैव गॉट इट राइट. द आंसर इज यू आर एब्सोल्युटली करेक्ट, बी मिस्टर अमित शाह. सो ही इज टेकन द एडिशनल चार्ज apart from the home ministry which he runs. This is to ensure increasing cooperation within the country and streamline processes for ease of doing business as well. The development of multi-state cooperatives. Central government has also signaled its deep commitment to community-based developmental partnership. The creation of a separate ministry also fulfills the budget announcement made by the union फाइनेंस मिनिस्टर. प्लीज टेक अ लुक एट दिस, इसको कॉपी कर लीजिए, लिख लीजिए. मैं चाहता हूँ आप लोग लिखिए, डोंट ट्रीट माई क्लासेस एज मियर क्विजेस. ठीक है रिहान, आप पूछ रहे थे मुझे कुछ देर पहले, बट जितना आप लिखेंगे दैट विल बी बेटर फॉर यू, बिकॉज दैट हेल्प सीमेंट द इंफॉर्मेशन. अदरवाइज वी आर जस्ट प्लेइंग क्विजेस, राइट? सो प्रकृति नोज माई फॉर्मैट, शी इज अटेंडेड अ लॉट ऑफ माई एप बेस्ड क्लासेस, सो आई थिंक दिस इज वेल नोन टू यू गाइज. Right, that is good, Rihan. Yes, static, Rihan, I've already covered quite a bit. So if you go visit the app, I really hope you have downloaded our app, which is on the Google Play Store. Once you download the app, you will be able to find, I've taken a lot of static GK sessions and I will be taking more. Don't worry, in the month of September, yeah, September's begun, my birthday month, we are going to have a lot of static GK quizzes. Do not worry, Rihan. Okay. Yeah, absolutely, Rehan. Just call us at this number. नीचे एक नंबर दिया हुआ है, आप उस पर कॉल कीजिए एंड यू विल रिसीव. सी द फ्यूचर क्लासेस विच आई टेक ऑन स्टैटिक जीके इन सेप्टेम्बर, उसका एग्जैक्ट डेट अभी तक प्लान नहीं हुआ है, बट मैं जो आपको बता रहा था कि आई हैव टेकन, तो आप ऐप पे जाइए, आप हमारा ऐप डाउनलोड कीजिए. द मोमेंट यू सी माई नेम, मेरे प्रोफाइल पे क्लिक कीजिए एंड आपको पुराने सारे क्लासेस दिखेंगे. देयर आर लॉट्स ऑफ फ्री क्लासेस, सो प्लीज गो थ्रू देम एज वेल. ठीक है, डज दैट मेक सेंस रिहान? राइट, लेट्स मूव ऑन टू द नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन. हैव यू कॉपीड दिस गाइस? प्लीज गिव मी अ कॉन्फर्मेशन इफ यू हैव कॉपीड दिस, देन आई विल मूव अहेड टू द नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन. या थैंक यू सो मच रिहान, नाइस टू गेट द विशेस. Right, please give me a confirmation if you've finish this. Okay, let's move ahead then. Okay, now the next two questions will be related to lawn tennis. Both of them will be related to Wimbledon. Wimbledon was held in July. So both these are July-based questions. Right now, in fact, is a very good time to discuss this because right now, as we speak, the US Open is ongoing. I hope you know there are four Grand Slams. Can somebody please write to me the names of the four Grand Slam events in a year? Four Grand Slam events in a year, please write them down to me, and preferably if you can put it to me in chronological order, and preferably if you can give me the circuit as well. I have discussed all this, YouTube pay and app pay. I've had classes on, you know, these kind of things. I really hope if you followed my sessions on YouTube. See, YouTube mein aap mere naam se search karenge to aapko purane mahino ke current ka current affairs kaafi dikh jayega. Right? Okay. So, Sofia Kenin, did she win the Wimbledon women's? We are only doing women's now. Next question is on men's. Sofia Kenin, Simona Halep. Simona Halep is from Romania. Ashley Barty from Australia. Naomi Osaka from Japan. Sofia Kenin, not sure. I think she's from Eastern Europe. But which of these four is the answer? They've all won at least one Grand Slam. At least two, three, and B, C, and D have. Okay, Rihan, thank you. I hope you are writing it down. ठीक है? आप एक picture लेके you can attach it as well so that I know you are doing it. Please tell me the names of the four Grand Slams. I will reveal to you the Grand Slams, but let us go through this one. Ashley Barty is the winner. She's from Australia. It is her second Grand Slam singles title. She's it's her first ever Wimbledon. She's won another. I think it was US Open she won earlier. So she's the world number one, defeated Karolina Pliskova from Czech Republic. In fact, as we are speaking last night, yesterday night, I saw the match of Karolina Pliskova. She is such a brilliant player. It clearly shows, you know, her enormous technique, excellent technique. So Barty has become the first Australian to win the Wimbledon singles since 1980. Last winner was the Australian Yvonne Goolagong-Coley, who won this thing, right? Exactly 50 years after her idol had won. She was not the last one. I'm just saying that she was the idol. And let's move on to the men's. And I must say, unlike the women's, where she is only second time winner, the men's winner is now a record holder jointly with two others. So I don't think I've given you an easy hint. Who won the men's Wimbledon? Is it Novak Djokovic, Matteo Berrettini, Rafael Nadal, or Roger Federer? Roger Federer is from Switzerland. Rafael Nadal from Spain. Matteo Berrettini from Italy. Novak Djokovic from Serbia. Berrettini yet to win a Grand Slam. Nadal and Federer have 20 each. Djokovic had 19 before this tournament began. But after winning this, yes, I'm revealing the answer. This was his 20th Grand Slam title. So now Djokovic stands equal with Nadal and Federer with 20 Grand Slam titles. Berrettini was the losing finalist. This was the first Grand Slam final he reached. I'm sure there'll be many more to achieve. Djokovic has also completed this unique phenomena of winning three consecutive Wimbledon. Remember, last year Wimbledon was cancelled. There was no Wimbledon in 2020 due to COVID. French Open had been delayed. Wimbledon was completely cancelled last year. So, technically, it's a third consecutive victory for him. Right, you've given me the answer, but none of you told me the Grand Slam names. Please note down the Grand Slams. The first one is Australian Open. The second is French. Third is Wimbledon, held in UK. And the fourth is Australian Open. Sorry, US Open. It's Australian, French, Wimbledon, and US Open. Right, let's move ahead. Okay, yet another sports question. This is a sport which I love much more. It's football based. And I remember waking up 5 o'clock in the morning to watch the match. I was not at home at that time. So I had to watch the match on my laptop. My laptop gave me great service. I saw it on Sony Live. Wonderful, platform that is. So who won the Copa America? Copa America, remember, is the premier football tournament from the South American continent, which along with Europe is the premier footballing hub. Is it Argentina, Brazil, Chile, or Uruguay? Chile won several Copa Americas earlier this decade. Argentina has not won an international tournament since 1993. So they actually broke a 28-year-old drought. Brazil, of course, are the giants. Uruguay last won the Copa America exactly 10 years back in 2011. when Diego Forlan used to play for them. Also up front, they had Luis Suarez and Edinson Cavani. What an amazing front three. Suarez, Cavani, and Forlan. That was truly terrific, right? But this time it was Argentina, Lionel Messi winning for all his other success in career. This was his first international trophy victory. He did win the Olympic gold medal, but that's of course slightly different. But these kind of mainstream tournaments, this was his first international victory. Okay, so Argentina won the Copa America title for the first time since 1993. They beat Brazil 1-0 at the final at the Maracana Stadium in Rio de Janeiro, famous stadium. Angel Di Maria scored the only goal of the match. Angel Di Maria is now a teammate of Lionel Messi. They used to be rivals at club level. Di Maria used to play at Real Madrid, staunch rivals of Messi's Barcelona. Messi, of course, remained in Barcelona. Di Maria had a stint at Manchester United for a year, but since 2015, he has been at Paris Saint-Germain. He's just started his seventh consecutive season there, and Messi has finally left his club Barcelona and boyhood club Barcelona and joined Paris Saint-Germain in France. Messi has been elected the joint best player along with Brazil's Neymar. Right? I hope you all got this explanation. Brazil was the wrong answer, Prakriti. It was actually Argentina. I don't think so. Isca PDF, I'm not really sure. But I'll work it out with the backend team if they can send. So I'm not sure how that is to be done. So I'll just, I'll get in touch with them regarding this. You can also call up at the backend. Okay, now enough of sports. Let's do some other more important stuff. Who has been appointed as a resident grievance officer for Twitter in India? I hope you know Twitter and Government of India. They had quite a few spats on a few things, and this basically continues from that trend. So, who has been appointed as a resident grievance officer among these? A very difficult question because it's a name. I'm not sure how many will be able to answer. So, let me straight away get to the point. It's Mr. Vinay Prakash, the resident grievance officer for India. The appointment announcement was made on the official website of Twitter. The appointment is mandatory for all social media companies under the new informal technology rules, information technology rules of the country. Right? Guidelines were issued. All social media intermediaries are to comply by May 26th. Right? These were issued in February, of course. Right, let's move on to the next question. Just a couple of questions now remaining. Right, Abiy Ahmed, he was a Nobel Peace Prize winner 2 years back. Seems a little strange considering there was a civil war last year, but 2 years back he did win. He's been elected as a prime minister for which country for a second consecutive 5-year term? His party, ruling Prosperity Party, they won a landslide victory. Right, so is it Nigeria, Ethiopia, Egypt, or Morocco? Which of these 4 countries is the answer? I repeat the hint which I gave you. He won the Nobel Peace Prize a couple of years back for ending a long-term border dispute with a neighboring country. The name of the neighboring country is Eritrea. Which of these is a neighbor of Eritrea? Eritrea. I'll also give you 3 more hints about this country, right? Even if you can't recognize the hint, but at least this will add to your knowledge. This country was one of the 2 birthplaces of coffee. You know, coffee Arabica grew in Arabia, and coffee Robusta, that variety was first produced here. The second hint was this was sub-Saharan Africa's first civilization. Now, I've also given you this hint, sub-Saharan. So obviously, 2 of the options are eliminated. And the third clue is this is the only African country which was never occupied by a European country. Every other African country had at some stage. Nigeria was a British colony. Egypt also British colony. Morocco, a part of Morocco was a Spanish colony. There's a bit of dispute on that territory. But main Morocco was a French colony. Ethiopia, on the other hand, although the Italians did rule for a brief period, that was between the world wars. We are not counting the world war years. Because during the World War years, even Germany ruled over France. So that does not mean France was a colonized nation, right? So I'm not including that. So Ethiopia is the only African country never to be occupied by a European country. In fact, both the Italians and the British had made attempts to capture. They couldn't. The British ended up capturing a part of Ethiopia. They took away Somalia, while Italy took away Eritrea. Those were two significant examples. But Ethiopia, the what is Ethiopia today, never was occupied. Also, one of the oldest countries where Christianity was practiced, although it's a Muslim majority country now. There's a significant, visible minority of Christians here. So, elected as the Prime Minister of Ethiopia for a second consecutive term, massive victory, you can see. And he's serving as the fourth Prime Minister of the Federal Democratic Republic of Ethiopia since 2018. That is correct. Rihan and Prakriti, both of you got it absolutely spot on. Do share, talk about my classes with your friends. Let more and more people, get the information. Right, let's move ahead to the next question. Are you guys done with it? Can I please move on to the next question? I also should have given you one more hint. Ethiopia is also the world's largest producer of a flower. Any idea which flower am I talking about? That flower has long been considered the symbol of romance. It has white in color, but the red color is more famous. I think you know which flower I'm talking about. We'll come back to that. Indian Navy recently received 10th anti-submarine aircraft P-81. From which of these countries? Let's take a quick guess. Russia, France, US, or Israel? I was talking of the rose flower, in case you couldn't guess, which is the symbol of romance. Ethiopia is the world's largest producer of rose. And in fact, there's an Indian company called Karaturi, which has a lot of farms in Ethiopia. Let's write that down. Indian company Karaturi has a lot of rose farms in Ethiopia. I hope you like this diverse information that you receive in my class. Right, so iska answer dekh lete hai. This is from a US-based aerospace company, Boeing. Boeing is one of the Boeing and Airbus, basically the two largest aerospace companies in the world. Airbus is from Europe, mainly from France. Boeing is from USA, based in Seattle, in the state of Washington, on the western coast, along the Pacific Ocean. Defense Ministry has signed this contract for eight of these in 2009, but in 2006 it signed a contract of four more. So it's a total of 12, I believe. So two more will be received at the last quarter of 2021. It's a long-range maritime reconnaissance and anti-submarine warfare aircraft, and a variant of the P-8A Poseidon, which is used by the US Navy. So very similar to that one. India was the first international customer of Boeing for this aircraft. Indian Navy inducted the first P-81 aircraft in 2013, while the ninth P-81 aircraft was received in November 2020. Just now received the 10th one. Anti-submarine aircraft, so they can attack submarines which are below water. So imagine this is on in the air. Air, say they will shoot missiles which will go past water, and they will attack submarines which are below the water. That is quite an incredible achievement. Yes, you are correct, Prakriti. It is indeed USA. And Rihan was absolutely correct about Rose as well. Yes, so was Prakriti. Very good. Let's move ahead then to the next question. Many of you got Ethiopia correct as well. I think this one is the last question. Absolutely correct. So, who has been sworn in as the new Prime Minister of Nepal? In Nepal, the last assembly, the existing Prime Minister tried to dissolve it. And so now there's a new Prime Minister, although elections are still due. So, we are likely to be having more elections later on. So, is it KP Sharma Oli? Is it Sher Bahadur Deoba? Pushpa Kumar Dahal or Sushil Koirala? Sushil Koirala, related to famous Bollywood actress Manisha Koirala, who starred in the movie Bombay and several others, Khamoshi. Khamoshi, of course, most famous for its songs rather than the movie itself, but Bombay, famous movie, and 1942, a love story as well, starring Manisha Koirala. she is from the same family. Anyway, let's go ahead and see the answer. The answer is Sher Bahadur Deoba. He's been PM for the fifth time. Nepal has had more than 50 prime ministerial changes in the last 60 odd years. It sounds shocking, but that's how it is. He has been administered the oath of office by the president of Nepal. Her name is Srimati Bidya Devi Bhandari, and she was the first female president of the country. He has been appointed prime minister under Article 76(5) of the constitution, which makes it mandatory for him to secure a vote of confidence in the house within 30 days of taking oath. As I said, the previous one was tried to be dissolved, eventually did get dissolved. That was by Mr. KP Sharma Oli, who has now left the office. Right, so I'm done with the question. I think you should start from January current affairs se. Yeah, absolutely harsh. Please don't think kitna time chala gaya hai. Ye dekhiye kitna time bacha hai aur aap kitna acha kar sakte hai. So you still have a lot of time remaining if you put your heart and soul into it. ठीक है, तो ऐसा बिल्कुल भी मत सोचिए कि क्या चीज होगा नहीं होगा. जस्ट योर बेस्ट शॉट एंड आई एम श्योर यू कैन डू एक्सट्रीमली वेल. राइट आर्यन, ओके, लेट्स मूव ऑन देन टू द नेक्स्ट स्लाइड. राइट, सो प्रीटी मच डन. दीज आर द फोन नंबर्स, 9650052904, ऑल्सो 8806130414. यू मे कॉल अस एट आइदर ऑफ दीज टू नंबर्स. सही प्रेप है तो लाइव सेट है. दिस इज समथिंग यू नोन फॉर अ वाइल नाउ एंड वी आर देयर ऑन यूट्यूब. ऑल दोज हु अटेंडेड द सेशन टुडे एंड लाइक इट, प्लीज प्रेस द बेल आइकॉन सो दैट यू रिसीव नोटिफिकेशन फॉर ऑल फ्यूचर वीडियोज. यस रजत, योर आंसर वॉज करेक्ट. यस यस रजत, एब्सोल्यूटली. टुमोरो इज माई थर्ड क्लास इन दिस सीरीज. टुडे वॉज द सेकेंड, टुमोरो इज द थर्ड. ठीक है रजत, चलिए. एज आई टोल्ड यू, सही प्रेप है तो लाइव सेट है. वी ऑल्सो हैव आर टेलीग्राम चैनल, प्लीज डाउनलोड आर यू नो डाउनलोड टेलीग्राम ऐप एंड बी पार्ट ऑफ द ग्रुप. वी हैव वेरी इंटरेस्टिंग डिस्कशन फॉर द बीबीए ग्रुप. आई ऑल्सो टेक अ लॉट ऑफ लॉ सेशंस, सम लॉ सेशंस, मोस्टली बीबीए बट सम फॉर लॉ एज वेल, जीके. एंड एज आई टोल्ड यू, वी ऑल्सो हैव आर ऐप. मैंने ये पहले भी बताया था, आई रिपीट दैट, इस ये हमारा ऐप जो है ये गूगल प्ले स्टोर पे है. इसको डाउनलोड कीजिए. वंस यू डू दैट यू कैन प्रैक्टिस टॉपिक वाइज क्विजेस एंड यू मे कीप अटेंडिंग लाइव क्लासेस. ठीक है, चलिए. आई एम डन विद द पीपीटी. इफ यू हैव एनी क्वेश्चंस प्लीज फील फ्री टू आस्क मी एंड आई जस्ट कीप इट ओपन फॉर अ मिनट और सो इन केस यू हैव एनी जेनेरिक डाउट्स एंड देन आई विल रैप अप द सेशन. यस, थैंक यू सो मच रिहान. सिलेबस, यस आर्यन, आई डू दैट. सिलेबस देखिए, एंट्रेंस एग्जाम्स में सिलेबस बताना बहुत मुश्किल है क्योंकि कोई ऐसा स्पेसिफिक सिलेबस नहीं आता. बट मैं आपको बताऊँ, जीके में दो ब्रॉड एरियाज है, स्टैटिक जीके एंड करंट अफेयर्स. करंट ऑल्सो इंक्लूड बिजनेस अवेयरनेस. ठीक है, तो ये ब्रॉड दो एरियाज है आर्यन, एंड फ्रॉम दीज एरियाज वॉट आई कैन से इज यस यस आर्यन, आई हैव सीन योर क्वेश्चन, आई हैव सीन योर क्वेश्चन. वो सडनली ब्लैंक हो गया, आई डोंट नो वाई. बट हाँ, तो जैसा मैं कह रहा था कि जीके में दो प्रॉड एरियाज है, करंट अफेयर्स एंड स्टैटिक जीके. डीयू चैट में देयर इज अ गुड मिक्स, दोनों टाइप के क्वेश्चन आते हैं, करंट एंड स्टैटिक. स्टैटिक में यू विल टिपिकली नोटिस दैट देर आर क्वेश्चन फ्रॉम इकोनॉमिक्स. एक एक क्वेश्चन हर टॉपिक से आते हैं, इकोनॉमिक्स, पॉलिटी, ज्योग्राफी, हिस्ट्री, हर एक से कुछ ना कुछ क्वेश्चन आता है. अब थ्योरी जीरो से पढ़ना मुझे नहीं मालूम अभी कितना कर सकते हैं. एक महीना मैं बार बार कह रहा हूँ इट इज एनफ, बट देन अगर आप कोई बुक जीरो से पढ़ेंगे, क्या पढ़ेंगे, क्या इंपॉर्टेंट है क्या नहीं है, वो थोड़ा मुश्किल होगा याद रखना. सो माई फॉर्मेट इज क्वेश्चन क्वेश्चन एंड मोर क्वेश्चन. लेट्स डू एज मेनी क्वेश्चन, लेट्स कीप एक्सपैंडिंग ऑन दोज क्वेश्चन. लेट्स नॉट जस्ट डू अ क्वेश्चन एज अ रट्टेबाजी. बट मान लीजिए हमने कोई क्वेश्चन किया ऑन लेट्स से विम्बलडन पे किया, मैंने तभी आपको बाकी ग्रैंड स्लैम्स के बारे में पूछ लिया. सो दैट विम्बलडन, बट यू कैन ऑल्सो डू दी अदर ग्रैंड स्लैम्स. आई स्पोक अबाउट माई द मैच विच आई सॉ लास्ट नाइट ऑफ यूएस ओपन, राइट? सो द आइडिया इज दैट यू डू वन क्वेश्चन बट यू एक्सपैंड इन टू फाइव सिक्स मोर. So that is the idea. Next couple of days, if you keep noting down the points, I'll try to cover as much of relevant current affairs as possible. ठीक है, आयुष, आई होप आई हैव आंसर्ड योर क्वेश्चन. एनीथिंग एल्स प्लीज, रजत और रिहान, आर्यन, एनीबडी? Prakriti, of course, she has answers to the question because she's been regularly attending classes on the app at least. Right then, I think the questions are done. Thank you so much, guys. Wonderful meeting you all. See you all tomorrow at exactly same time, 10:30 a.m. in the mornings. Till then, thank you so much, everyone.